we'd still be together until now!
Edward ended things, right? If he wants to get back with you, that's on him and not on me.
You must have forgotten you always get my hand-me-downs!
That's enough!
You need to stay away from Edward.
But that's exactly what I've been doing.
Are you telling me that Edward is more important than your own flesh and blood?
That's what I'm saying, and I can't imagine life without
him. Everything that happened last night, that shouldn't have happened at all. Sarah, I'm sorry.
Last night I gave myself to Edward. I thought if I give myself to him, he will love me back, but he didn't.
I found the woman I would love for the rest of my life. She says she can't love me back.
Listen to me closely. Stay away from my daughters. I'm telling you right now. You don't want to know what I'm capable of doing to protect my family.
For as far back as I can remember, my identity was attached to yours. I want to be free from you.
Lucille, you should give it a rest.
I need to do this to find out what Mom really wanted to say before she had the accident.
Nobody else should know what Barbara already knows.
Yes? Why are you all looking like you've seen a ghost?
Why would you do
this? I love it since I no longer have to see you every time I face a mirror.
I don't want you to stay mad at me because you matter so much to me.
How dare you even flatter me? I know you slept with my sister.
Kara, that was a mistake. You're the one I love.
It's not love. It's obsession.
The reason I'm here is to ask for a copy of the CCTV recording of the night of the party.
I'm sorry, ma'am, but we don't have the CCTV footage. The footage of the day Mrs. Acosta's accident happened has gone missing.
What?
What do you think you're doing here?
I was just hoping I could have a talk with Mr. Ishmael.
What do you need from me?
Yes, I know Antonio and my mother aren't on good terms, but they will never hurt my mother.
All we're trying to do here is our job, ma'am.
I came here hoping to ask you to forgive me for everything that
Forgiveness? Do you think it's that simple, Edward? After you disrespected my own daughter?
I understand that there's no way I can take back what I've done, but please believe me when I tell you that I had no intention of hurting Sarah, and I've made it clear to her that we're no longer in a relationship.
And that's what I have a problem with. You're done. You tell her you're over, but what you're showing her is something else.
Can you blame us for being so furious with you?
I've given you enough time to explain. You can go now. Well, what are you waiting for? Get out of my house!
I'm in love with Kara.
What did you just say?
I love Kara. I want to be with her. And I would do anything to convince you to accept my love for her.
How dare you! As if it wasn't enough for you that you hurt Sarah the way you did. Now you want to get Kara too?
Of course not. That is why I'm standing here in front of you. I needed you to see that my intentions for Kara are pure.
I'm not going to let you get near either of them. Get that through your head. If your intentions are as pure as you say, from the very start, then neither of them would have gotten hurt.
But
get out of here.
Tell me what it is I have to do to make things
Edward,
right.
There are mistakes that you can never take back, and this is one of them. And what I'm telling you now, that what you've done to Sarah is so unforgivable, you're just wasting your time. Get out of my house now!
Where are you going?
Sarah?
I'll be stepping out for a while.
You were going to see Edward.
Oh, come on, Mother.
Go upstairs.
Mother?
Go back upstairs.
Mother, when did this place become a prison? You're treating me like a criminal.
That's because what you're doing is wrong.
I'm pretty sure it's not a crime to love.
It's a crime against yourself to be giving too much to a man who refuses to love you back, especially if you're willing to give him everything. Don't give me a reason to lock you up in your room, because I'll do that if I have to, just to stop you. Go up.
Thank you.
We're going to the 7th floor. Why'd you pick the 8th?
I feel like it. Can we go around some more?
Okay. On the 8th floor. What shall we do now?
Let's explore the place.
Explore? Okay, let's try this way.
Of course you're here. Mother sent you to be my guard today, huh?
Huh? Why would I have to keep watch over you? What are you, a prisoner? What were you charged with?
I fell in love.
You crazy girl. Did you really fall in love, or did you lose your mind? Oh, my sweet, beautiful darling. I have news for you. There's a go-see you'll want to go to.
What's the go-see for?
A shampoo commercial. Too bad. You cut your hair off, but we can do something about that. We can get you extensions. Wasn't that one of your dream jobs? To have a shampoo commercial?
Thank you, but now's not the right time.
Not the right time? You used to be beyond desperate just to find these kinds of jobs.
Well, a lot of things have changed. Look at this. I actually have money now. My other dad gives me money. Besides, I won't have time for this.
What are you busy with? What do you do when your mom won't even let you out of the house?
You know my mother as well as I do, Itoy. She'll soften up eventually. I'll just ride this out for now. And then I can finally work on getting back together with Edward.
Sarah, I don't know what to do with you anymore. You've lost it. You used to be so much better than this. What happened to you and why do you keep obsessing over this boy?
That's because when I was younger, I didn't know how to love. But now I know what real love's supposed to be and that's why I'm never letting Edward go.
Listen to yourself, Sarah. There are billions of men in the world and Edward is just one of them.
I don't care about other guys. He's the one I love. Besides, it wouldn't have gotten messy if Kara hadn't gotten herself involved.
Forget it. You don't deserve that shampoo commercial. You should be a star in a vinegar commercial because you're way too sour.
And the fire leapt out from its mouth. And both the prince and the princess were scared of the dragon. What if they burned?
Father, father, are they going to die in the end?
But love will save the day. The prince and the princess held their hands together. They joined forces, and with that, they were able to beat the evil dragon. With the power of their love, they were able to fulfill their own destiny. To be together, and to be happy for the rest of their lives. And they lived happily ever after. The end.
Father, father, tell us another story, will you?
Another one? That was my third story. Aren't you sick of them yet?
No way, Father. When you tell us your stories of far-off places, we feel like we're right there with them. Dad.
Kara, you should prepare for this. I heard the policemen talking to your mom, and they want to talk to us.
What?
They're starting a full investigation.
What happens when they uncover what it was that Grandma found out? We'll be marked as accomplices.
Don't worry about that. I made sure there's nothing to find, so if the police talk to you, don't tell them anything. Don't say anything. Just tell them you know nothing.
With everything that's happened, do you really still believe we can prevent them from finding out? That's exactly what you told me before, but Grandma found a way around it. And now look what happened to her. How many more lives will be put at stake just for this?
Kara, I know it's not easy. But it's not just your sister who will be affected. Have you forgotten? There's Laura and Ishmael, the whole family. All their lives are going to be ruined if our secrets are revealed. Do you want that to happen to them? Are you going to let them get hurt? Are you going to let the lives of your family weigh on your conscience like that?
Kara. Kara. Kara, let's talk.
Edward, can you please? Leave me alone.
Kara, wait. I need to talk to you.
Edward, there's nothing left to talk about that we haven't already talked about. You're the one who refuses to listen, so you can just let
it go.
That's
not true, Kara. We've got so much more to talk about. Like this.
What's that?
Kara, I know you know who I was all this time. When we hung out together, when my dad had a heart attack, Kara, you know all this. I was that kid in the hospital who was with you that day. In the province, you were the only friend I had back then. Now I understand why I feel this way when I'm with you.
Edward, that doesn't mean anything.
Kara, it means everything. You see it, don't you? This is destiny. Even after all those years, after everything that life threw at us, fate brought us back together.
Edward, that's enough. Destiny doesn't exist. It's just a coincidence. And that's just a meaningless toy. If you didn't even bring that with you today, I wouldn't remember it at all. Your childhood story is lost on me.
Does it really mean nothing to you? Or are you denying yourself this truth?
You know what? You believe what you want to believe, but don't drag me into it.
Kara, I know that deep in your heart. You know that what I'm telling is true.
You know what I feel deep down inside? I feel like this is ridiculous and I can't stand you. Edward, I thought we could be friends, but you're starting to make it more difficult for me. I have enough problems of my own to keep up with. So can you please not be one of them? Just go. I don't need you in my life.
Oh, miss!
I'm sorry.
It's okay.
Good morning, ladies.
Hello, Father.
Well, good hello. Morning. How have you been doing?
Oh, my goodness. Huh? What took you so long to get here? We'll be late to the neighborhood ballroom party. Oh, my friends are going to get so jealous when they finally see just how good-looking my new boyfriend is.
Would you like to dance with me right here? Come on.
Good morning, good morning, good morning.
Father Tyler.
Good morning.
Why don't you lie back down and rest? Thanks for dancing.
Good morning.
Good morning, Father.
Good morning.
Here.
You know, I agreed to be your girlfriend so quickly because you're really such a good dancer.
Oh, but you dance better than I do. Okay, rest now. Father Tyler, here are all your things.
They look so happy right now, just after seeing you. But with me, they're always frowning, especially when you're not here.
And they insist on calling me Father too, even if I'm not a priest.
If I didn't know you any better, I'd say you hated seeing me here.
Because I'm not dense, you know. I see what you're doing, you and Itoy. You might as well call the armed forces over and tell the whole squadron to watch over me.
That's a bit much. Can't you just say I'm just here to hang out with you?
Hey, Addy, help me out a bit, please. I need to get out of the house, so I need you to tell my mother that you're going out with me.
Shh. I heard that. Hey, Andy, don't you give in to this girl, do you understand me? I don't want to lose your mother's friendship all because of your stubbornness. Do you get me?
Okay, I get it. Fine.
You guys need to relax. Why are you all ganging up on me?
Whatever. You stay right here, okay? You're not going anywhere I can't see. I'm going to stand by the gate so I'm sure you can't sneak out of the house.
Okay, Itoy.
My goodness.
Do you think this is a game? Why is it so hard for you to follow your mother's orders? We're all just looking out for you, you know?
I really don't care. You know, let's not waste time. Can you just go online and tweet about Haze Band? They need more social media noise.
What?
Just do it, okay? Just do it. Hello, Radio Amazing. I just want to request that you play a song. The Mahal Kita Teka Lang song by Haze Band. Could you play it, please? Oh, really? Cool, thank you. Okay, what was the other one?
101.9, I think.
Nope, wait a minute. There's another one. I don't see you tweeting, Andy.
I'm tweeting.
Keep tweeting and don't stop until your fingers bleed.
Haze Band.
Hello? DWGV? Oh, hello, yes. I was just wondering if I could make a request for a song by Haze Band. Mahal Kita Teka Lang. I dedicate it to my love. Thank you. Awesome.
M-O-R.
Give me that.
Andy, give me my phone.
Why do you keep doing this, Sarah? What do you even want from Edward? You're giving him all this when he doesn't want it and he never even asked for it. Do you know what you're doing?
Andy, just give me back my phone. Give me back my phone. Come on. I told you. I'm still on a mission to bring back the love we once had, remember? You get it, Andy? It's a mission that I need to finish. It started when Edward gave me attention when I uploaded the video of his band. So you see, even if I'm stuck in the house all day, I can contribute to that. If I can help him out with his career just like I did before, then he might love me again.
I'm really trying, but sometimes I can't simply understand you.
You don't really need to understand my methods. If you love someone, you do everything for them, right? That's why I'm doing all this. And that's why you should keep tweeting so we can help his band become a trending topic. Come on, do it! Help me out!
My battery's dying.
Then go charge your phone!
Take it.
Thank you, Father.
Do you mind?
Do you really think that the universe is fair?
Yes, of course it is. But sometimes the universe balances out in ways we don't understand. We might misunderstand the signs, but that doesn't mean fate isn't on our side. Do you want to talk about it?
All my life, I've been surrounded by lies. And now all those lies are coming back to haunt me and the people I love. I've already hurt so many people. And it's hurting those who have done nothing but give me their love unconditionally. Those who gave me their entire lives. And I don't know how to fix it.
The universe always has a way of coming together and helping you figure it out when you need it to.
I'm still waiting for that help to arrive.
You know, everything that happens to us happens for a reason. You'll get to a point where you'll understand all of it. You shouldn't give up, okay? It'll be okay.
Father?
Keep it. Looks like you still need it.
Thank you.
No, we should try going... Oh, hey!
There he is.
Edward!
Hey, Edward!
We haven't seen you in a while.
I see you guys all the time.
Hey, Edward, what happened to you?
Nah, ignore it, it's nothing.
We do see you all the time, but you stay only for work. Because as soon as we're done practicing our songs, you leave us in your trail and we don't see you again.
Edward, don't you like us anymore? You're hurting Jason's feelings, man, look at him.
Shut up.
There's someone new in your life, isn't there? You're blushing. It's true, isn't it?
So who is this girl? And when do we get to meet her?
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, come on.
Yeah, man, come on.
Just make sure she doesn't bump into Sarah. I wouldn't want to see her when she's angry.
Guys, you've met her already. And you've all hung out with her before. Except you didn't know it was her. You thought she was Sara.
But how? That doesn't make sense.
It's Kara. As in Sarah's twin sister, man. She's actually been here a few times. Only we didn't know it was her.
She'd come over pretending to be Sara? Did that have anything to do with that woman who made a scandal here? Wasn't that her mom?
Yeah, that's her mom, Lucille.
Wow, that sounds like it's really complicated, man. You should be ready for a few more slaps in the face.
That's right.
But I will never give up.
Ooh.
I will fight for Sarah.
Whoa!
Yeah. That's how you do it.
You do that, Edward.
Awesome.
You're the
what
man.
A guy.
Honey, please stay strong.
Mr. De La Rosa? Miss De La Rosa, would you mind so much if we talked for a few minutes?
What's the problem? Do you have an update for us about the investigation?
The search for the stranger that was seen with Mrs. Acosta is active and ongoing, but that's not what we're here to talk to you about. We were just hoping to ask you a few questions, both you and your daughter. For starters, we were looking to confirm your whereabouts right around the time the accident occurred.
As far as I know, Carol was at the venue proper and I was at the bar. But as soon as I heard the shouts, I went directly to Barbara.
Was there anyone with you who would be able to confirm where you said you were that night?
There was no one with me, but I'm sure you'll find someone who saw me there.
You see, we were told that you don't exactly get along with Mrs. Barbara. Is this true?
Oh, Barbara and me fighting? That's not true at all.
Our investigation so far has implied that your mother-in-law didn't like you, and your wife just confirmed this to be the truth.
Okay. We didn't always get along. But it's your usual in-law squabbles. But that gives me no reason to want to hurt her like this.
Give me 5 milligrams diazepam. IV now.
Yes, doctor.
Where are you going, Sarah?
Oh, I'm going to that audition, the one Itoy referred me to.
Huh?
Mother, you don't believe me, do you? If you want, you can go and call Itoy. I'm going to be with him the whole time. I thought what you wanted was for me to try and move on. But how am I supposed to do that if I'm stuck in this house forever with nothing to do but relive the heartbreak all over again? Mother, you want to help me move on this way, right? Come on, please.
You better come straight back home.
Of course, Mother. Thank you so much. Don't you worry about it. I'm sure I'm going to ace this audition. Gotta go.
Sarah. You know I love you, right? I hope you know why I'm doing this.
I love you too, Mother, so much.
All right, go. You don't want to be late.
Thank you, Mother.
Could you explain what happened this time?
The swelling in her brain hasn't slowed down, and it's only been getting worse. The swelling is directly affecting her brain functions. Now, if this continues the way it's been going, this may result in organ failure.
Oh my gosh.
We've already given her some medicine, intravenously, to try and maybe ease the major swelling in her brain.
But is there a chance she'll get better? She has to wake up eventually, right?
Honestly, only time can tell at this point. We're giving her the best treatment we can. To try and get your mother to recover.
Oh, good afternoon. Oh, yes, here. I got you a few pastries. These are for you.
I don't want them, thank you.
You should really try these, though. I swear they're the best there is.
Why are you here? And how did you find out where we live?
I've always been a very resourceful person, so I did my research and asked around. And now I'm here hoping to spend some quality time bonding with you.
What? Just a second. Who are you anyway? And why are you doing this?
You just need some time to get to know me. It won't take too long for you to realize that your son and I belong together.
You're so pathetic. Sweetie, I want you to know something. You're not the kind of girl I want for my son. And based on what I see, it comes as no surprise that he broke up with you. I won't even question why Edward would choose Kara over you. After all the times I've seen you, I can easily understand which of you is better for Edward. And that girl is not you.
I didn't realize your words had to be so harsh.
I'm just being honest here. And now you can leave. And take your pastries with you.
Thank you.
Dad, what happened to Grandma that night was an accident, right?
Why are you asking me this?
Well, it's just... Sada told me she had absolutely nothing to do with it. And when Grandma fell down the stairs, you were there.
Do you realize what you're asking me? You sound like you're accusing me of this.
No, it's not that. I'm sorry. It's been a really complicated situation and I don't know what to think. But don't you feel bad for Mommy? It's gone way too far. Now Grandma's life is on the line because of all this.
What difference do you think it'll make if anyone owns up to the truth? You'll ease your conscience a little? Have you ever thought about what the overall effect of this will be? Especially to your mom?
But don't you think it'll only get worse? If we allow Mom's suspicion to grow, you know her as well as I do. She's never going to give up investigating.
Okay, Kara. You want to tell her? Tell her everything you know. But before you do that, I need you to kill me first. Because I'm willing to face death, then deal with the consequences of the truth. That's what you would do to me, Kara. I'm much better off dead.
Dad!
I can't allow you to ruin our lives like that, Kara. Do you still believe that I'm only keeping our secrets to preserve my own pride? Do you really think you're the only one who's getting hurt? I'm protecting our secrets to keep the integrity of our family intact. Because I love your mom to the ends of the earth. And if she finds out the truth, I know for sure she'll find a way for me to lose everything. Everything I've ever worked hard for. The company, the life that I've worked so hard to achieve. So, Kara, if you're willing to accept the torture this will put me through, then do it. I leave it all up to you.
Right. Go to sleep, okay? Hey, Nico. Is everything all right?
Father? Would you say it's nice outside?
It is, yes.
I've been stuck inside this hospital for so long that I can't even remember what it looks like anymore.
You want to see the outside world? I have an idea. But shh, this is a secret.
What are we going to do?
Come on, let's go. You're not scared of heights now, are you?
Not at all.
No?
Nope.
Careful now.
Wow.
You see? Didn't I tell you it was nice outside?
Yeah.
I've had enough! I'm sick and tired of everything!
Go call for help. Go, go.
I saw a woman on the roof who's about to jump. Someone help her, please!
Okay, come on, hurry! Come on!
Miss, you don't have to resort to this. Life will get better, okay?
What? Have you seen Kara?
No, I haven't.
Whatever you're going through right now, I know you can get past it. This is not the solution.
It's not what you
think. Miss, you can talk to me about it, okay? Let me help you out. I'm right here, okay?
Thank you.
Okay, Miss, you're safe with me. Okay?
Listen, you know what? It's really not what you think.
Miss, I understand, okay?
Wait, weren't you the guy at the chapel?
Yes. Look, Miss, whatever problem it is that you're facing right now, taking your life, that is not a solution, okay?
No, I really wasn't going to do that. I went up there to find a way to let out all my frustrations. I just wanted some place to yell, to express my emotions.
Miss, you can't properly address your problems if you're too busy trying to justify them.
You're completely misunderstanding this. I wasn't going to kill myself.
Okay.
But thank you all the same.
Hey, sir.
Kara?
We're okay. It's okay.
Kara.
There's no problem here.
Mom! Tell me, what's happening here? Was that you? They said someone was going to jump.
Mom, it was a huge misunderstanding. I just went up to the edge because I just needed some time alone. That's all it was. It's no big deal, and this guy helped me out.
What were you thinking going up there? Be more careful next time, okay? Please excuse us. So sorry about this. My daughter is not going to attempt to kill herself.
Sorry about that.
All right, then.
Thank you, sir. Are you sure you're okay? Do you feel any different? Does anything hurt, hon? Let's go to the doctor and get you checked downstairs.
No, I'm okay. I'm sorry. I'm really all right, Mom.
Let's go.
Hey, thanks, kid.
This door has buttons? What happened to the old-fashioned doorknobs?
What are you doing here?
What? Am I no longer welcome in this house? It's a little too late for that. Now I'm here, and so is the food.
No, I mean, I thought you were with Sarah today at that audition.
Did she go to that? She told me she didn't want to go because she wasn't quite ready. She was too emotional over Edward or something.
So you never went with her?
Oh, my. I knew it. Your daughter's gone a little crazy. Looks like she's going through a serious rebellious phase. Look at her rebelling all over again.
Guys.
Oh, hey,
hey
Sarah.
Hey, Sarah, how you been?
Sarah.
Loving
how
your
you
new
been, girl?
Looking good.
You know, you're looking better every time we see you.
Where's Edward?
He's not here. He'll be here eventually, but probably much later tonight.
Would you know where he is?
You know how he is. He's always doing his own thing.
I know, right?
That guy can disappear for days.
Yeah.
Well, that's too bad. This was the only day I could sneak out of my house. I was really hoping I could talk to Edward today. I was hoping I'd get to apologize for what my dad did to him. Oh, by the way, this is for you.
Thank you.
Oh, this is why we love you.
I see two boxes.
Thanks, Sarah.
Hey. Right. Pass the box this way, man.
Hey, guys. Everything? I need you to be quiet. Excuse me.
You hear that? Stay quiet. Come on, give me the box.
Go on, open it.
Hello, Mother.
Sarah, where are you?
I thought I told you I'd be at an audition today.
Audition, yes. Where is it? I want to drop by.
Oh, no, you don't have to. I'm almost heading home anyway. If only you'd see me perform for the piece, you'd be so impressed.
You're really sticking to your story. You know what impresses me? Your skill in lying to your own mother. Go home. Right now. Right now. We need to have a serious talk.
Mom, why are you looking at me like that? Believe me, I wasn't trying to kill myself. It was just a misunderstanding.
I know that. There's no real reason for you to want to do that, right? But I got to thinking, what if something bad had happened to you? I don't know what I would do. I'm pretty sure I'd lose my mind if something had in fact happened to you, especially after everything that's already happened to your grandmother.
Mom, I'm fine. You don't have to worry.
I hate this. I hate hospitals. Nothing good ever happens in this place. I hate it here, and I hate having to be here. The longer I stay here, the sicker I feel about it. And you know what else I feel every time I'm here? There's a constant heaviness in my chest. I hate it, Kara, but there's nothing I can do about it. Because of Mom, and because of you, all those days when you were a really sickly child. Promise me, you'll take care of yourself, okay?
Mom, I promise. I won't add to your list of worries. There's too much on it already. I just want to be able to help you.
Sarah, how long are you going to keep this up? How long are you going to keep lying to us?
Mother...
Come on! Did you really think I wouldn't figure it out? That I wouldn't realize you were lying? That I wouldn't know you made something up just to run off with Edward?
Well, if you didn't lock me up in this house, I wouldn't have had to lie about it.
Is that your reason for lying to us? And you dragged Itoy into it too?
That's only because you wouldn't have let me out if I told you I'd be going to Edward.
You understand the reasons we've forbidden you from seeing him.
I understand.
Okay, then tell us why. Why do you insist on doing this?
Just because I understand doesn't mean I agree with what you're telling me not to do.
You don't need to agree with our rules. You have to understand and respect the boundaries we've made. They're there to protect you. We're your parents, Sarah. We have a pretty good idea what's best for you. And Edward is not it.
I know, I get it. You guys know everything. You're my parents and I love you, but you don't understand. Edward's the only one I need.
You're saying you need Edward? Wouldn't you be able to breathe if he wasn't next to you? Would you die?
Yes, Mother, I would. It would definitely kill me.
Stop and take a moment to listen to yourself, Sarah. You once had a life of your own, but now it revolves around one guy. It's embarrassing.
I would never be embarrassed of loving someone. Please forgive me, but there's nothing that either of you can say or do that would change how I feel for Edward.
Are you okay?
Yes, ma'am.
I'm just relieved someone found you there. I don't know what could have happened if no one did.
I have to admit, I was actually quite nervous.
You know, Kara, there are people that come to us at the perfect time who are sent to help us, and sometimes they show up at the time we most need them. That's just how destiny works.
Do you believe in destiny and that sort of thing? Because to me, whatever happened earlier was all just a coincidence.
You want to know what it is I believe? I believe everything that happens, happens because it's meant to be. There are no accidents. Wouldn't life be more wonderful if you believed in something like that? Kara, I know you're going through an awful lot right now. Maybe you should start believing that there are powers greater than all of us that guide us through life.
Edward, please. I've had enough. Could you stop following me around?
Hey, it's just me, okay? And who's Edward?
What are you doing here?
I'm just checking up on you, okay? I mean, I didn't want you to go back up to the rooftop.
You don't have to worry about me. I don't have plans of going back there, and I'm not trying to kill myself.
All right, but still, I know you're going through a lot. And that's the hardest part, isn't it? Feeling like you're all alone?
You don't need to watch over me, Father.
Why do you keep calling me Father? Who do you really think I am?
Well, of course, out of respect, I mean, you're a priest, right?
I'm not a priest. Just call me Seb. Sebastian.
Wait, what? How are you not a priest? The last time I saw you, you had those robes for a priest.
I'm a sacristan of Father Tyler.
Oh, okay. But I told you about my problems only because I thought you were a priest.
Is being a priest a requirement to effectively listen to your problems?
You don't understand. I wouldn't have opened up to you if you weren't a priest. I trusted you.
And you can still trust me.
You know what? I appreciate the intention, but I really don't want to be a burden to you or to anyone. You can relax because I'm not going up to the rooftop and I'm not going to try to kill myself, okay?
What's your name?
Kara.
Kara? Where's your cell phone?
What?
Give me your cell phone.
Why?
Just give me your cell phone.
Takara. This is my number, okay? If there's anything you need, if you just need someone to talk to, if you feel like you're almost ready to give up, and you feel like there's no more hope, do not hesitate to call me. Anytime. And I'll answer.
I thought you were a good listener. Didn't I just say I'm not going to the rooftop and I'm not going to kill myself?
Kara, it's not a bad thing to ask for help, especially if you need it. You know that, right? And now that you have my number there, just call me anytime, okay?
I'm still shaken. What if something much worse had happened to Kara instead?
Lucille, stop overthinking it. It was all an accident, okay?
I know that. I'll try not to think about it.
Oh yes, what's new with the ongoing investigation?
No new updates.
They asked me if I knew anything about what happened, and they mentioned someone told them that I didn't get along with Mom.
I tried talking to them about it. There was no point in asking you questions. That wasn't something you could have done to Mom.
It's all right. As long as I can help. I see nothing wrong in talking to them, but I really don't know anything about what happened that night.
They just really need to dig harder to find the last man that Mom was talking to. He's really the only one who can tell us everything that actually happened. Antonio, I am not giving this up. Not until I figure out who that man is.
Miss, I need you to come with me.
What's going on?
I said come with me!
Wait a minute, tell me what's going on. Where are we going?
Hey, I heard this guy's gonna serenade this girl.
This is for you!
Nagmahal ako noon nang higit sa buhay ko. Ngunit ako'y iniwan niya. Damdamin bang iyo'y pipigilan? Mahal kita, pero teka muna. Hindi ko pa alam kung puso ko ay handa na. Naubos na itong lanang natira. Minamahal kita, pero teka muna.
That was great.
Oh, that's so sweet.
Wonder what's next.
Go to him.
Come on.
Say
come
something.
On.
Come on. Say something, girl.
Don't be shy.
Oh, come on. Say yes to him.
Come on. Go up to him.
Go ahead.
Go to him.
Sorry.
What's going on?
Oh no!
She didn't like the song.
Kara!
What happened?
Kara! Kara. Sorry. Are you okay?
There's a guy coming after me.
Huh?
I need to hide.
Come here. Over here. Who is it?
Kara. Kara?
So what have you found so far?
One thing. We were able to pull up the phone records. We acquired it from the telecom company, and we discovered the last man that Mrs. Acosta spoke with.
So who was it?
He was the investigator your mother hired.
Investigator? Well, where is he? I need to talk to him.
You'll get your chance in a minute. He's just done being interrogated by my colleagues. Come here, they want to talk to you.
Were you the same man that my mom was talking to on the night of her party? Who are you and what was your connection to her? What were you talking about?
It should be made clear that I did nothing wrong. I'm just a private investigator that Mrs. Barbara hired.
Private investigator? Why in the world would she even hire a private investigator? Who did she have you investigate this time?
Your daughter, ma'am.
My daughter? Well, as far as I know, she'd stopped doubting Kara a long time ago because she'd already proven that her parents died long ago.
Those were just Mrs. Barbara's orders, ma'am. She had me do a background check on your daughter. I was just doing my job.
Did you find anything substantial? What was the last thing you told my mom?
What's up?
Nothing really. It's just so absurd. I was running away from him. It was a lot like one of those movies where the lead male star pulls off this grand declaration in front of all these people, and then I ran away, instead of actually enjoying it. I guess I just couldn't appreciate it.
Are you honestly that terrified of love?
It's not love. It's just his idea of what love is. You know, loving someone isn't defined by the huge romantic gestures.
You know, you look like a romantic. But honestly, you're really cynical.
You're calling me a cynic? Can't I just be realistic?
Realistic? If that's the case, then your reality's looking pretty grim.
Well, yes. That is true. I guess my reality is pretty grim. Where do I start? My grandma is in a coma right now. I'm keeping secrets from my mom. She doesn't know my parents are alive, and I have a sister. And my sister, she hates me. She's convinced I'm stealing Edward from her, but she doesn't understand I've been avoiding him. I'm sorry. I shouldn't have told you all that.
What?
I'm so sorry.
But why?
Because you shouldn't be stuck listening to all my rants.
Kara, this is good for you. Because if you keep it all in, it'll weigh on you forever. And didn't I just tell you that I'm willing to listen? I mean that.
Are you really like this? You help people out even when you don't know them?
But I do know you. You're Kara.
You know what I mean. You really don't know me. All you know about me is my name.
Well, I know you well enough to know that you're a good person.
I hope one day I could say that about myself, too.
Let me help you. Look, I know a place. Just come with me.